On behalf of the government of Georgia and the Georgian women, it's my great pleasure and honor to welcome you to this event. I would like to express my support to every single action and idea aimed at the empowerment of women in industry and innovation. I want to say thanks to the organizers of this event, UNIDO, FAO, UN Women, and the government of Italy. Every success achieved by women and every step made by her is comprised by unique experience and skills. In addition, every defines success differently. A successful woman is a change maker who can inspire, motivate, and get the best out of every single person. Women does not take a lead or does not assume a leadership role simply because someone entitles her to do so. Instead, a true leader is born when trust has been established on both sides and you can get a courage, guidance, and what is most important, show your own experience. As a female leader, I'm always on lookout to connect with and learn from incredible women who have cultivated their own amazing business and entrepreneurship. Women's economic empowerment is not simply a concept or part of an important international agenda. It's a way to freedom, independence, and access to better future. Having in mind all these ideas, Georgia takes steps toward building society, respecting gender equality, implementing sustainable development goals, and desiring to leave no one behind. Various factors such as cultural, religious, and economic obstacles hinder the economic empowerment of women, and that is why we need joint efforts to eradicate the challenges and stimulate new opportunities. To improve their knowledge and participation in the labor force on an equal footing with men that reasonably emphasizes in the policy documents. We do have men-dominated sectors, especially in agriculture. Selecting the value chain or sector to target may be the first fundamental choice that we have to make when planning their interventions. The bottom line for the value chain selection is clearly the economic dimension, particularly the potential for market growth or creation, value addition and employment generation. However, when the ultimate goal is to develop agri-food value chains that are not only efficient but also inclusive and socially sustainable, it is fundamental that the selection be based on the integrated set of criteria that combines economic, environmental, and social concerns. Standard approaches for value chain selection seldom explicitly consider gender equality. However, examining the potential of a value chain to benefit both women and men is important, especially when designing interventions that aim to combine gender equality and value chain development objectives. It is possible to work on every value chain using a gender-sensitive approach, like, for example, entrepreneurship. We mean it that increasing the role of women is bringing significant progress in economic development and economic crisis. So I wish you all the successful event, and I'm sure we will get the chance to meet in person and share our unique leadership experiences.